सो वेलकम बैक स्टूडेंट्स. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी सम इम्पॉर्टेंट सम्स फ्रॉम एक्सरसाइज 2.3 दैट वी डिस्कस्ड इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो. एंड वी विल ऑल्सो डिस्कस सर्टेन एग्जाम्पल्स फ्रॉम द ऑप्शनल येट इम्पॉर्टेंट एक्सरसाइज दैट इज एक्सरसाइज 2.4 सो दैट दिस चैप्टर पॉलिनोमियल्स विल बी कम्प्लीटेड. Now, last time we saw exercise 2.3 and some of the important sums. Remember, that time I discussed that this pattern of sums where two zeros are given and other two zeros are to be found out is actually very important pattern of question, maybe 3 or 4 mark question. I discussed one example the previous time. I told you that you can try this question number 3 and I will discuss this in this today's video. So, let us start. Obtain all other zeros of this polynomial 3x to the power 4 plus 6x cube minus 2x square minus 10x minus 5. Now remember students, this is a polynomial of what degree? 4. So how many zeros are possible? 4. Sorry. So how many zeros are possible? 4. So out of the 4 zeros, 2 of its zeros are given. Under root 5 by 3 minus under root of 5 by 3. So we need to find the other two zeros, right? So let us actually start with this question. Now, if one zero is root 5 by 3, another zero is root minus 5 by 3, what does it mean? X is one of the zeros and it is root 5 by 3. Another zero is minus root 5 by 3. Okay? Now, what we used to do, we used to convert these zeros into factors. How we were doing? X, this will come this side, minus root 5 upon 3 is equal to 0. Similarly, X, this will come this side, plus root 5 upon 3 is also equal to 0. Now, because both of them are factors, we will write it like this. X minus root 5 upon 3. X plus root 5 upon 3 is equal to 0. Now students, seeing this, do you remember any identity? A minus B, A plus B, what was it? A square minus B square. So applying this identity, what we are getting? X square, root and root will be minus 5 upon 3 is equal to 0. Now this becomes a very important part of our question. Why? This actually becomes our divisor. So g of x equal to x square minus 5 upon 3. Correct? Look at the question. This becomes our dividend. So p of x is equal to 3x to the power 4 plus 6x cube minus 2x square minus 10x minus 5. So students, what will be our next step? We will actually divide p of x by g of x and we will obtain the quotient. Then using division algorithm, we will try to find out our zeros. Okay, now as you are seeing students, let us divide p of x by g of x. I hope you remember the method. First term of dividend and first term of divisor. So 3x to the power 4 divided by x square. So what will be our quotient? 3x square. Okay, this method should now come orally after certain examples. So first quotient part is 3x square. Correct? Now what we are going to do? We are going to multiply this by the quotient. X square into 3x square. 3x to the power 4. Okay? Now minus 5 by 3 into 3x square. I will show you once only. Minus 5 by 3 into 3x square. 3 cut. So this will be minus 5x square. Remember, we have to write it under the like power. Minus 5x square will be there. So we won't be writing it here. We will be writing under the like power, that is square. So minus 5 by 3 into 3x square will be minus 5x square. Reversing the signs, minus plus. So this is eliminated. Plus 5x square minus 2x square will be 3x square. And we will copy down these terms. 6x cube plus minus 10x minus 5. Okay. Continuing in the same way students. First term 6x cube upon first term. So this will be 6x. So what will be our next quotient? 6x plus 6x. X square into 6x. What is the answer? 6x cube minus 5 upon 3 into 6x. So it will be minus 10x. We will write minus 10x under the like power, not here, but here minus 10x. So reversing the signs, we will see that both the terms are actually eliminated. Copying down the rest of the terms, 3x square minus 5. Now it is very easy. What will be our next part of the question? 3x square upon x square will be plus 3. So 3x square into 3 is 3x square. Minus 5 by 3 into 3 is 3, 3 will be eliminated. Minus 5. And we will see that terms are eliminated. Now, what we are going to do? We are going to actually apply our division algorithm to find out our other two zeros. What was the division algorithm? P of x equal to g of x into q of x plus r of x. Correct? Now, P of x, we know that this is this term. So, we will just mention P of x for now. Okay? Now, what is g of x? This one, divisor x square minus 5 by 3. Okay? And, here q of x will come. Q of x is quotient. What is our quotient that we obtained? That is 3x square plus 6x plus 3. And remainder is 0, so there is no need to actually write it. Now, students, it is the actual time to find out the other two zeros. As you can see, x square minus 5 upon 3. Okay, that means x plus root of 5 by 3 minus, into x minus root of 5 by 3. These are our original two zeros that we were given in the question. So, we will not focus on this. We will actually focus on this part. Now, if you see this part, students, what we are seeing, there is some number common. What is the number common? 3. So, what we will do? We will take that number common 3. We will write the same term, x square minus 5 upon 3 into x square plus 2x plus 1. So, this 3 is common. We will not focus on that for the zeros. This is already a part of the question. X square minus 5 by 3. On solving, we are getting two zeros. That is root of 5 by 3 and minus root of 5 by 3. So, we won't be solving it again. What we will focus on for the other two zeros? We will focus on this part. So, x square plus 2x plus 1. If you know the identities very well, this will be x plus 1 whole square. Now, equating them with equal to zeros, what we are getting? X plus 1 equal to 0. Again, x plus 1 equal to 0. So, the third 0 is minus 1. And the fourth 0 is also minus 1. So, in the question, two zeros were given. What was the first 0, students? It was under root of 5 by 3. Second 0, it was minus under root of 5 by 3. And the third 0 is minus 1. 4-0 is also minus 1. So, this is how we will be solving such kind of questions. Okay, students. So, now let us see question number 5 from exercise 2.3. Easy question, but a little tricky question, but because we need to follow certain rules. What is the question? We have to give examples of polynomials. What are the polynomials? P of x, that is dividend, g of x, that is divisor, q of x, that is quotient, and r of x, which is remainder. That satisfies the division algorithm. It is written for the certain cases of example. Now, before I start, I want to be very clear with the division algorithm. P of x equal to g of x into q of x into plus r of x. Now, degree of remainder can be 0, and also degree of remainder has to be less than the degree of the divisor. So, take these points into consideration before we start. Now, we have to give examples of all the four types of polynomials in this case. So, let us start with the first one. What is the first one? Degree of P of x should be equal to degree of Q of x. Okay. Directly giving the example would be not easy for you to understand, students. So, what we will do? We will go stepwise and write the division algorithm first of all. What is the division algorithm? P of x equal to G of x, that is divisor, into q of x plus r of x. Now, what do we want in the question? Degree of p of x should be equal to degree of q of x. Okay, now pay attention. If I suppose degree of p of x to be 1. Okay? Similarly, if I suppose degree of q of x also to be 1. Because why I am supposing? I want finally the degree of p of x to be equal to the degree of q of x. So, let me suppose degree of p of x to be 1, degree of q of x to be 1. Now, what will happen if I also suppose degree of g of x, that is divisor, also to be 1? Let us see if it is correct or not. Suppose degree of q of x is 1. Suppose we take an example x. We have also supposed degree of g of x to be 1. So, if we take an example x, what is x into x? X into x will be x square. So, if we are taking degree of q of x to be 1 and also we are taking degree of g of x to be 1, x into x will be x square. That will be how many degrees? That will be a degree of 2. So, which will not satisfy this? I hope you are understanding what we did. We wrote the division algorithm. We are supposing that degree of p of x is 1. We are also supposing that degree of q of x to be 1. Now, if we suppose degree of g of x also to be 1, if these both degrees are 1, so variables can be x and x, x into x is x square, which is a degree of 2, which will not satisfy p of x. So, what do we prove? Degree of g of x cannot be 1, it has to be 0. That means, 0 means this will be what? This will be a constant number or a constant term. Now, what will happen? Constant number and constant means degree of 1. So, constant number, suppose we are taking a, okay, and constant this degree is 1. So, a into x is still ax, that is a degree of 1. So, it will satisfy the equation. Now, what about remainder? Just let us move upwards. What we have written about remainder? Degree of remainder has to be 0 or it has to be less than degree of g of x. Students, what is our degree of g of x? Degree of g of x is 0. So, it cannot be less than 0. If it is less than 0, then it will not be a polynomial. So, what should be the degree of remainder? Degree of remainder also has to be 0. I repeat, how we concluded this? See the rules. What are the rules for remainder? Degree of remainder has to be 0 or degree of remainder has to be less than degree of divisor. What is the degree of divisor? 0. It cannot, the degree of remainder cannot be less than 0. It cannot be less than 0 because if it is less than 0, it will be minus 1 and that won't be a polynomial. So, what is the degree of remainder? It has to be 0. Okay. So, what we have incurred from this, I would like to repeat once more. We have written the division algorithm, correct? We suppose degree of p of x to be 1. We suppose degree of q of x also to be 1. We initially suppose degree of g of x to be 1. But what will happen? If degree is 1, x into x will be x square. That will be a degree of 2, which will not satisfy this. So, what we decided? Degree of g of x to be 0. 0 means it is a constant. Okay, that so constant we suppose to be a or any random number. Now, for degree of remainder, the rule is degree of remainder either has to be 0 or it has to be less than degree of divisor. Now, if degree of divisor is 0, we cannot take degree of remainder to be minus 1 because if it is minus 1, then it will not be a polynomial. So, degree of remainder is also 0. Now, let us find out all the polynomials based on the equation we have given. We will write this once. Okay. So, p of x equal to g of x into q of x plus r of x. What we supposed? P of x, we decided a degree of 1. Let us take any example of degree of 1. Suppose we take x plus 3, correct? G of x, we decided to be a constant. We will not suppose any number directly, so let the constant be a. Okay, q of x, again it is a degree of 1. So let us suppose any 1 degree polynomial, say x plus 1, and r of x also we suppose to be a constant, that means let us say it will be b. Okay, so this is our basic equation. What we need to find? We need to find the values of a and b. Now pay attention what I am doing. Shortcut: x plus 3 equal to a x plus a plus b, correct? Now what I will do, आई विल कंपेयर दिस विथ दिस, दैट इज ए एक्स इक्वल टू एक्स, करेक्ट? दैट मीन्स ए इज इक्वल टू वन. आई होप यू आर अंडरस्टैंडिंग. एक्स अपॉन एक्स विल बी वन. आई विल कंपेयर दिस विथ दिस, ए प्लस बी इक्वल टू थ्री. वॉट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ ए? वन. सो वन प्लस बी इक्वल टू थ्री. सो वॉट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ बी? बीज वैल्यू विल बी इक्वल टू टू, करेक्ट? आई होप यू आर अंडरस्टैंडिंग वॉट आई डिड. वन डिग्री आई टुक एन एग्जाम्पल कॉन्स्टेंट ए, अगेन वन डिग्री आई टुक एन एग्जाम्पल कॉन्स्टेंट बी. ओके, आई इक्वेट, आई जस्ट मल्टीप्लाइड हियर. आई एम कंपेयरिंग एक्स विथ दिस, सो ए इज इक्वल टू वन. आई एम कंपेयरिंग थ्री विथ ए प्लस बी, सो ऑन पुटिंग द वैल्यू ऑफ ए टू बी वन, बी इज इक्वल टू टू. ओके, सो लेट अस प्लेस दिस वैल्यूज इन दिस इक्वेशन. से एक्स प्लस थ्री, वॉट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ ए? वन. एक्स प्लस वन, वॉट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ बी? प्लस थ्री. सो स्टूडेंट्स, वॉट वी वर आस्ड इन द क्वेश्चन, वी वर आस्ड द वैल्यूज ऑफ ऑल फोर ऑफ दिस, करेक्ट? सो एज पर द एग्जाम्पल, दिस इज आवर पी ऑफ एक्स, करेक्ट? वन इज आवर जी ऑफ एक्स, एक्स प्लस वन इज आवर क्यू ऑफ एक्स, एंड थ्री इज आवर आर ऑफ एक्स. सॉरी, नॉट थ्री, बी इज टू. सो टू इज आवर आर ऑफ एक्स, करेक्ट? सो इफ यू आर मल्टीप्लाइंग वी विल गेट बैक दिस. सो द डिविजन एल्गोरिदम इज ऑल्सो वेरीफाइड. सो इन दिस वे वी विल बी सॉल्विंग सच काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चन. इट इज ईजी बट लिटिल ट्रिकी बिकॉज वी नीड टू फॉलो द रूल्स. ओके, यू कैन पॉज द वीडियो एंड सी द एग्जाम्पल वंस मोर. यू विल गेट एन आइडिया ऑफ हाउ टू डू दिस. Okay students, so let us see the second example. The second example, again we have to find out all the polynomials, that is p of x, g of x, q of x and r of x. But the condition here is degree of q of x should be equal to degree of r of x. That is quotient's degree and remainder's degree has to be same. So as you can see, I have already written the division algorithm along with the rules. So let us start. Now, what do they want in the question? They want degree of r of x and degree of q of x to be same. Okay, no problem. Let us start supposing. Let me suppose that degree of q of x is 1, correct? Let me also suppose that degree of r of x is also equal to 1, okay? Because this kind of questions can be supposed and easily solved. Now, let us pay attention on the second part of the division algorithm. What does the second part say? That degree of r of x is always smaller than degree of g of x. Okay, degree of r of x is always smaller than degree of g of x. Now, if we suppose that degree of r of x is 1, so can degree of g of x be also 1? No. Degree of g of x is always greater than degree of r of x. If degree of r of x is 1, degree of g of x will be what? It cannot be 1, it will be always greater than 1. So let us suppose degree of g of x is greater than 1, that is 2. Now go back to the previous question. Okay, we suppose that degree is 1, so this is suppose variable x. Suppose degree is 2, variable is x square. Students, what is x square into x? It will be degree 3. So that means degree of our p of x cannot be 1, cannot be 2. It has to be 3. Let me just acquaint you with once more. We had to find out a polynomial equation where degree of q of x equal to degree of r of x. Okay. So degree of q of x we supposed to be 1. Degree of r of x we again supposed to be 1. Okay, now as per the rule, degree of r of x is always smaller than degree of g of x. So if degree of r of x is 1, g of x has to be greater than that. So we suppose that degree of g of x is 2. Now for p of x, okay, what we are doing, we are multiplying both. If degree is 2, variable is suppose of x square. If degree is 1, variable is suppose of x. What is x square into x? X cube. So degree of p of x is always 3. Okay, now students, so let us give the example of what we actually decided. We will start from this. R of x and q of x are actually having the same degree. So we will suppose that both the things are actually of same, you can say, polynomial. Say suppose r of x is we will take x plus 1, correct, because of degree 1, and let us again suppose q of x to be same, so that we can easily give the example x plus 1. So this is also of degree 1, this is also of degree 1. Students, what about this degree 2? If remainder is x plus 1, degree of this is 1, degree of this is 2. So to just simplify the example, what shall we keep? We will keep this x plus 1 square. I hope you are understanding what we did. We first of all decided what are the degrees that we want in the example. Both this q and r of x are the same degree, so we suppose that both are the same variables. Degree 1, suppose we are taking a small variable x plus 1. Degree 1, for simplicity, we could have taken x plus 2, x plus 3, but just for simplicity, we are again taking x plus 1. Now, this is of degree 2. So, if remainder is x plus 1, this can be taken, actually it can be taken so many things, but if remainder is of degree 1, for degree 2, we can take a very simple example, that is x plus 1 whole square, okay? Now students, what we need to do, we cannot directly suppose p of x. So what we will do, we will in rough solve this part and actually we will obtain p of x. So let us solve this in rough. Say x plus 1 whole square, what is x plus 1 whole square? X square plus 2x plus 1 multiplied by x plus 1, that is this, plus x plus 1. First we will multiply this. X square into x, that is x cube, 2x into x, that is plus 2x square, 1 into x, that is plus x, correct? 1 into x square, that is plus x square, 1 into 2x, that is plus 2x, 1 into 1 is plus 1, and plus x plus 1. So students, what we are getting? X cube, square terms are, I think, 2 plus 3x square. 1 degree terms are actually 3 plus 4x and 1 plus 1 is plus 2. So what is our p of x, students? Our p of x is x cube, okay, plus 3x square plus 4x plus 2, okay? So I repeat what we did in this question. We wanted degree of q of x and r of x to be same. We suppose both the degrees to be 1. As per the rule, degree of g of x cannot be, you can say, smaller than degree of r of x. So if r of x degree is 1, g of x will be 2. Now 2 into 1, that is x square into x will be 3. So degree of p of x we took to be 3. Now there can be, you can say, such kind of questions can have different answers. For simplicity, what we suppose? For degree 1, x plus 1. Again for degree 1, x plus 1. This cannot be less than this r of 1's degree. So we suppose it to be x plus 1 whole square. Very simple. That is x square plus 2x plus 1. Now, it is not possible to find out this term directly. So what we did? We did certain rough work. We calculated this. And what we are getting? We are getting p of x to be x cube plus 3x square plus 4x plus 2. So what we wanted in the question, we wanted the all four values, that is p of x, q of x, g of x and r of x. So this is our p of x, correct? This is our g of x, this is our q of x, and this is our r of x. Remember one thing about certain kind of questions, there is not any concrete answer. There can be different kinds of answers, different kinds of methods. Directly also answers can be given, but correctness of that is not, you can say, verified. So what we are doing, we are just using certain small tricks and tips, and using that we are finding out the solution. Even in the previous question, students, you saw that we could have directly written, but what we are doing, we are actually using certain tricks, using the division algorithm. And first of all deciding what degrees we have to use, and then we are giving the example, and then we are finding all the p of x, g of x, q of x and r of x. Here also we did the same. We actually first decided what degrees we have to first suppose, and then we use some supposition and shortcut methods to find out the answers. I again repeat, no specific or concrete answers are possible, or no specific or concrete methods are possible for such kind of questions. You have to use such kind of methods, and you can pause the video and see the questions once more to have a better understanding. Okay, now students, let us see the last question. That is, degree of remainder of x has to be 0. Okay, so very simple. Degree of remainder of x has to be 0. That means it will be a constant term. Correct? Constant term will be having degree 0. Okay. What we can see that if this is having degree 0, g of x will have degree more than degree of remainder. So let us suppose degree of this has to be 1. Simple. Now we don't have any restrictions with q of x. Let us say for one example we are taking q of x degree to be 1. We also know degree of 1 into degree of 1, x into x will be x square. So under certain cases degree of p of x has to be 2. Correct? This is not any concrete method. We can follow other method also, but what we did, because degree of r of x has to be 0, so we took the degree to be 0. G of x degree is always greater than r of x degree, so degree is 1. We don't have any restriction with q of x. We again suppose degree of q of x is 1. If this is 1, this is 1, x into x will be 2, so degree of p of x has to be 2. Let us try one more example. Say degree is 0. Because this is 0, this has to be more than that, so it is 1. Here we can say, suppose degree is 2 and 1 into 2 will be 3, so degree is 3. Okay, so multiple examples we can give. Let us say we are following the first approach of this one. Okay, degree is 0, so let us suppose any constant term 1. Correct? Degree is 1, so we will suppose x plus 1. Correct? Again degree is 1, so again let us suppose x plus 1. For simplicity, in between plus is there, plus 1. Students, we can verbally just see x plus 1 and x plus 1 will be x plus 1 whole square. Correct? What is x plus 1 whole square? X square plus 2x plus 1. Okay, I hope you are getting. X plus 1 into x plus 1 is x plus 1 whole square. X square plus 2x plus 1 plus 1 will be x square plus 2x plus 2. So if we are giving certain example, so this will be our you can say p of x, this will be our g of x, this will be our q of x, and this will be our r of x. Correct? Let us say one more case. We want to see this case. Okay, say this is 0, that is degree is 0. So let us say simplicity wise we will take 1. Degree is 1, so say let us suppose x for simplicity. Degree is 2, so let us suppose x square for simplicity. And on solving, what we are getting? X square into x is x cube plus 1. So I hope this is getting really simple now. This is our p of x, this is our g of x, this is our q of x, and this is our r of x, that is degree 0. Okay, so as per me, students, this question 5 that we have discussed, it is simple, but yet it is little tricky. Okay, so what I will suggest you, you can pause the video again and again. I hope for all the three examples, I have given you a concrete method by which supposition can be done. I am not telling that you follow this method only. You just go through the method, have some clarity. What I did in every question, I first decided what degree we are choosing. Then we give end for the example and not directly going into the example. As you can see, in every question, we first of all decided what degree we will choose using the rules of division algorithm. Then we went for the example and certain shortcut methods. Same we did in this question here, because the condition was little simple, we went for multiple examples. So you can pause this video, see the examples again and again. At the beginning of the video, we decided that we will go for exercise 2.4 also. But since this video prolonged a little bit, we will go for exercise 2.4 in the next video. Okay, so go through the video and practice the questions. We will meet in the next video. Thank you and have a nice day.